في البداية بحب أرحب بالجميع في الجلسة الأولى لهذا المؤتمر، وتقديرا لضيوفنا اللي أجوا مسافات بعيدة، بالتحديد المشاركين من دول أجنبية. ارتأيت أنه المقدمة لضيفنا الكريم دكتور سيرين سيبي تكون باللغة الإنجليزية، هي مقدمة بسيطة، وبعدين المحاضرة بتكون باللغة العربية، المحاضرة والنقاش اللي بلي راح يكون باللغة العربية. In appreciation for our international guests, I opted to introduce our dear guest, Dr. Sirin Sebe, in English. The actual presentation will be in the Arabic language, and the following discussion will be in Arabic as well. Dr. Sirin Sebe was born in 1949 to the prominent, obviously, Nisaybe family that traces continuous presence in the city of Jerusalem back to at least the 7th century, a history that very few Jewish or Christian families enjoy in this holy land. It is worth noting to our international participants in particular that the Muslim Nisaybe family holds the keys as custodians to the Church of the Holy Sepulchre since the 12th century, when Salah ad-Din captured Jerusalem from the Crusaders and returned it to Muslim rule, an honor that they continue to hold until the present day. Dr. Nisaybe is the president of our sister university, Al-Quds University in Jerusalem, and a professor of philosophy since 1995. He is a UNESCO chair of freedom of expression and also co-chairman of the Israeli-Palestinian Science Organization, and he also recently co-founded the People's Voice. He is a fellow in a number of prestigious international institutions, including the Baker Institute for Public Policy at Rice University, the Radcliffe Institute of Advanced Study at Harvard University, Balliol College in Oxford, the Woodrow Wilson International Center for International Scholars in Washington, D.C., among many, many others. He earned his bachelor's degree in philosophy, politics, and economics from Oxford University in 1971, and his doctoral degree from Harvard University in Islamic philosophy in 1978. Dr. Nisaybe taught many courses, including cultural studies, Islamic philosophy, political theory, freedom and identity, logical relations in Islamic thought, symbolic logic, and critical thinking. The interests of Dr. Nisaybe can be categorized in the following major areas: rights and what we do with them when they conflict, such as the rights of return and of independence, personal and national identities, violence and nonviolence, religions and Jerusalem, civil disobedience, boycott, and normalization. Dr. Nisaybe is widely published on political and philosophical issues, in particular on the Israeli-Palestinian conflict, human rights, and the issue of Jerusalem, peace, and religious aspects. Some of his recent publications include The One State Solution, Violence, Rationality, and Reasonableness, Final Status, Jerusalem and Return, Is God Part of the Israeli-Palestinian Conflict of Rights, Once Upon a Country, a Palestinian Life, No Trumpets, No Drums, On the Limits of Freedom, and What Next, among many other publications. In addition to his widely circulated publications translated to many languages, Dr. Nisaybe has delivered numerous presentations around the globe on these topics. On top of his scholarly academic work, Dr. Nisaybe played an important role in politics as well. During the First Intifada, he played an instrumental role as an architect of the strategy of civil resistance from 1987 to 1993. He also held a number of political positions, including a member of the steering committee of the Palestinian negotiations team, a member of the Palestinian National Council, and representative of the Palestinian National Authority in Jerusalem. He has had a number of thought-provoking positions in relation to some political positions, including the recognition of Israel, annexation of binational statehood, and the right of return. These positions may be considered controversial, and some of which have been misread or misinterpreted. A number of these positions have also become mainstream in Palestinian politics in later years. The list of memberships in international foundations and the number of citations and international awards received around the world deem him a true scholar. Today, Dr. Nusseibeh will give the first presentation in this conference entitled Religions and Their Interpreters, Barriers or Bridges. The presentation will be approximately 30 minutes in length, to be followed by approximately 45 minutes for discussion and comments. It is a great privilege and honor to welcome Dr. Nusseibeh to deliver his presentation.
Shukran kathir. Thank you very much. Let me just say this in English, actually, that I'm really very impressed by this introduction. I hadn't expected either such a... So I'm really very, very grateful. So let me switch back into Arabic. And the reason I want to do this is so as to be able to speak slowly, speak to primarily the Arab audience, in order later on to be able to create some kind of dialogue. I do not have so much a message to convey as I have a wish to create a dialogue. This is the reason why I wish to focus my conversation in Arabic. أريد أولاً أن أشكر جامعة بيت لحم على لدعوتي لهذا المؤتمر لرئاسة الجامعة طبعاً ولعمادة دراسات الدينية. ويشرفني أن أكون حاضرا بينكم هذا اليوم. أريد أن أعبر أيضا عن سعادتي وعن شعوري بالشرف لحضور غبطة البطرك ميشيل صباح الذي أنهى كلمته هذا الصباح والذي أصر على البقاء والاستماع. فكل الاحترام والتحية له ولسماحة المفتي مفتي بيت لحم ولكافة الحضور. قبل أن أبدأ أريد أن أستحضر ذاكرتين تخصا البطرك ميشيل صباح، قد يتذكرهما وقد لا يتذكرهما. الذاكرة الأولى تخص يوم ما عندما توفي أخي فيصل الحسيني وجاء البطرك ميشيل صباح إلى بيت الشرق. كان جثمان المرحوم فيصل لا زال في الطريق من الخارج إلى فلسطين، وإذا كان يتذكر جلست بالقرفصاء أمامه وطلبته كقيادة دينية بأن يقوم هو والقيادات الدينية الأخرى مسيحية وإسلامية بدور أكثر فعالية في محاولة لجلب السلام للشعب الفلسطيني. وكنت ولازلت أعتقد أن الدور الذي يمكن أن يلعب رجال الدين في هذا المجال هو دور أساسي وقيادي، وأنا أتأمل حقيقة أن يقوم رجال الدين المسؤولين بهذا الدور، لأنه كما أظن فالعلمانيون ومنهم أنا يبدو